That shit was hard real quick.
That shit was crazy, man. It was like 8 minutes.
In and out, nigga. For real.
Zach Hurst on Behind the Lens, man. Come on. Let's do it.
This is the beat?
Oh, I don't know.
Come on, give me to the
go ahead and add me up.
That's that old mess swing. Oh, that's what did the beat?
Yeah.
Oh, this for the city?
Go ahead and add me up.
Don't bear it doing numbers, spread the wordy cousin. Don't bear it doing numbers, spread the wordy cousin. That new Fabby piece just cost me 30 cousin. Two Maseratis outside, go for 100 better.
One time. You gotta cut me up because I can barely. The one that's on there, I can't hear.
Yeah, I got you
wrong. And then did my voice crack when I said that?
Yeah, just do it over.
Looking like I rob a magic show. I'm a movie star, every day a fashion show.
Tell fair pieces for the whole damn crew. I get thumbs up when I'm in that old school stool. Last year did 2 million, this year I'ma do 5. Libby been to 10 countries, man, before she hit 9.
And that's the truth, too. That's hella funny.
Add it up, how they stack it up. That's why they mad as fuck. Fab a nut, he in Africa, that nigga acting up. I'm a movie star, every day a fashion show.
Every
time you and him link up, it's
just... Whole shot?
Yeah.
That's my guy. I love that nigga, man. I need a good nigga, man.
Yeah, that's cousin.
For real.
Yeah, just text me too. I forgot about it because he sent it to me the other day and I was like, oh shit, I forgot. I was like, nigga, when you got influenced, my nigga, this is like pre... social media, a like it was like right, boom, right. It was right on the curve. Like I think it was like
MySpace,
and it was right on the
Black
edge.
Planet was out when that came out.
Well, sure, but it was like right on the edge of.
Right. It was still weird.
Changing social the narrative.
Right.
How you doing?
Good. How you doing?
I'm good, baby. It was right on the edge of that, right? And I was like, bro, when you pop in, my nigga, you could say anything, my nigga. Niggas don't give a fuck no more, cause it was like my nigga. This was around the time where I was really wanting to show that I could really rap.
Right.
Like, go to my early battle stages and shit like that. I was really on, like, some content and I really wanted to just show, like, rapping. But I was like, niggas don't give a fuck, my nigga. I could say anything, like, Shabubala Boopy or some shit. Niggas gonna be like, oh, that's dope. And nigga was like, so, if you listen to how I set that shit up, I was like, nigga, I bet you I can make them say. And I really bet my nigga. I was like, bro, I bet this will fuck around and pop off.
Real shit.
And so, I was really making a mockery of that shit.
Right. Yeah, I already.
But because I just feel like, once you're in position as an influencer, whether you use that right or you use that wrong, your influence influences. So, as right now, that's why I say, like, even with this last interview that I just did on the Breakfast Club, I'm not about to influence motherfuckers in a way to where I know that I'm irresponsibly leading someone. I got to be able to say, man, I got to be mindful of the content that I allow to leave. But once you become an influencer, now they own you. Now they looking. Now they watching. So you could just get, you could get it going, bro. They be in your business, bro. Once they get in your business, a nigga just got to keep going, man.
Gotta keep flying.
G.O.D. You ready for me?
Yep.
All right.
Jump back at 9 sacks.
Bought an 8 for 50. Try to bag up 9 sacks. You know, with that 90, I get 8 one time. With that 90, buy a quarter. Bought an 8 for 50, try to bag up 9 sacks. With that 90 by a quarter, and then I'm back. With that 90 by a quarter, nigga, I fly back. Bought an 8 for 50, try to bag up 9 sacks. With that 90 by a quarter, then times that. With that 90 by a quarter, then times that. 18 skimpy sacks, 188 to flip the half. By lunchtime, I got zip money with a hit. By lunchtime, I got zip money. 18 skimpy sacks, 180 flip the half. By lunchtime, I got zip money and I'm flipping bags. Bought an 8 for 50, try to bag up 9 sacks. With that 90.
by a quarter, then times that. 18 skimpy sacks, 180, flip the half. By lunchtime, I got zip money and I'm flipping back. Young nigga hustling, trying to help my little kids. Say to cut the heat off, so cold, I feel chills. I'm getting this right now, but I know the real. This life just changed, I'm still here. I came from the jungle with an ape swing on vine. Be careful who you swing on, cousin, we carry nine. Little nigga only nine on the grind, he selling dimes. Daddy doing time. Mama on the hood up. We was busting knocks in the TLs like, on the scooter.
It's amazing what you expected, like, dude. For real. Like, you don't know about it. That
shit. Real. Niggas, niggas don't know how far me is. Niggas don't know. Real
short. That shit was hard, real quick.
So fast. That shit
was
crazy, man.
It was like 8 minutes. In and out,
nigga. For real. Mind how big you feel you are, how popular you still you think you are. Nigga, it's 8 billion people in this world, and you out your motherfucking mind if you think all 8 billion people know who you is.
No.
So, nigga, you got to work till you don't got to introduce yourself no more.
800 motherfuckers won't cry no motherfucker.
You get what I'm saying, bro? So, your main thing is to say, nigga, okay, I'm not finna complain about somebody not knowing me, or I'm not finna complain about somebody not recognizing my work. What I have to do is keep working. You want to talk about the shit that you did? Keep doing. You feel me? Because then they'll talk about it. Your relevancy will be your legacy. So now when a nigga talk about you, now he got to review everything that he overlooked. Like, damn, I just got on that nigga. Let me see. Okay.
Yeah, the nigga I remember. Don't nothing get overlooked. That's resume,
come on,
baby.
Man.
You get marched down.
You bound, nigga. Be like, cuz a nigga ain't got my resume. Nigga, right, like, here. Damn, you got...
Catalog, baby.
You did all that?
Yeah, catalog.
Nigga, I didn't know you did that.
It will surface again.
Come on, my nigga.
It will surface again.
My nigga, that what is overlooked will eventually be reviewed. So I had to put in my mind, nigga, I can't be mad at Rolling Loud, nigga. Look yourself in the mirror, nigga, and take blame, take accountability. They come into Oakland, you shouldn't be able to notice. Nigga, ain't no sleeping in. They should automatically be like, oh, let me get that. Because I'm working that hard. Yeah. I'm putting the music out. I'm going through the proper channel.
But it take a real motherfucker like to notice that.
Self-accountability.
And admit that.
Self-accountability. So, nigga, as soon as Mozzie called me, we go do Rolling Loud. Nigga, as soon as I got off stage, nigga, I'm coming to the studio, nigga. Let me get on my work. Nigga, I ain't finna be playing. I'm finna get out there where they can't overlook me. To where they can't say, oh, we getting slept on. Because niggas take the bitter approach, and they get lackadaisical towards their work. So now you got a chip on your shoulder. You feeling like, man, niggas ain't fucking with me anyway. You bitter, nigga.
Numbers, to work,
don't nothing come better for bitter.
Man, that cost me 30 calories. Two Maseratis, man, that shit cost me
with a gang.
Don't nothing come better for bitter. So you better get on your shit, nigga.